Welcome back. So 2 hours west of the Twin Cities, the state is taking a step toward righting past wrongs for the original residents of our region. The Department of Natural Resources is closing Upper Sioux Agency State Park and giving the land back to the indigenous community that is right next door. John Croman's been following this one for a couple of days, and he's on the show tonight. Hi, John.
Hey, Jenna. We're talking about a part of the Minnesota River Valley originally granted to the Dakota people as part of a deal with the U.S. government, a deal marred by broken promises.
A place of Holocaust for our people, if you truly boil it down to a concept that can be understood.
Kevin Jensvold chairs the Upper Sioux Community, which a month from now will take possession of 1,280 acres of state land along the Minnesota River that since 1963 has been the Upper Sioux Agency State Park.
Well, if you look at it in a historic context, it's a 160-year effort, to right the historical wrong that was inflicted upon my mother's people.
Petahoyeto means makes the fire blue.
Jensvold, as leader of the Yellow Medicine people, reminded lawmakers last year at Sovereignty Day that the state capital itself sits on land the U.S. government never finished paying for.
This is Dakota land. This is original treaty land that was paid $2,000 out of $200,000 commitment that Zebulon Pike made on behalf of the United States of America.
I think the Upper Sioux State Park being returned to the Yellow Medicine people is incredibly powerful. Sometimes we talk about land back as a hashtag, and really what it is really intentional policy work that the DNR did in partnership with the Yellow Medicine people, with the Upper Sioux community.
The Upper Sioux Agency was at the epicenter of a broken treaty that in 1862 led to starvation, which then led to attacks on settlers and a war with the U.S. that ended with the hanging of 38 Dakota men and the forced removal of their families from the Minnesota River Valley and from the state.
Because of that, there's a solemnness to the land. There's healing that needs to take place.
The DNR said the park was already way overdue for upgrades, and Highway 67, the only access to it from non-tribal land, was closed due to damage from flooding. So from that standpoint, it makes sense to return part of the land that was originally given to the Yellow Medicine people in a treaty.
It's a pretty easy choice, frankly, because we can do the right thing with respect to the community's request. And since we need to invest heavily to operate some kind of recreational facility in that area, we can choose another location to do that.
The DNR says it's working to find other recreational opportunities in that part of the Minnesota River Valley, which is something the feds asked for when they signed off on this. Jana.
John, what about the tribes? Do they have any plan for the land or just let it stay pristine?
The chair, Jensvold, basically said this is something they're going to think about and deal with over a long period of time. They've waited 168 years to get this land back, and they're going to take their time and decide what they want to do with it.
Makes sense. Thanks so much, John Croman. Appreciate it.